just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Robinson from the six. He's tackled at the 33. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. They'll spread the field with five wide. And a quick throw. Warner picks up about 5 yards on that hookup. Tackled right around the 34. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Now it's 3rd and 9 coming up. Ball on the 34. And he's tackled in the open field. Mills gains about 5 yards on the play. Douglas is back deep to return the punt. Brought down at the 23-yard line. The Golden Gophers, having a wide receiver like this, I think sometimes it even helps a young quarterback, because this kid goes out there, he works hard in practice every day, and I think he really lifts the whole offense.
I think he does. I think he's almost like having an extension from the coaching staff into the locker room with the players. He's a guy that makes big plays, but I think he takes it upon himself to be able to help out with some of the other receivers, make sure that they're all on the same page, understand the route adjustments, understand everything that goes on with being a wide receiver and the importance of blocking. So all the little things that seem to add up and make big plays, I think this guy totally understands his responsibilities being a go-to player.
Second down, 15 to go. Ball on the 18-yard line. Got it and brought down immediately. Out to his receiver, and down he goes at the 30-yard line. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. He's at midfield. Makes it to the 44. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
And he throws it away. Second and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. There's a strike complete. There's a fumble. It's recovered.
It's not like receivers don't practice hanging onto the ball all week. This is just a case of the defense creating a turnover.
So the question on this one is whether or not the ball carrier's knee hit the ground before the fumble popped loose. The coach wants to challenge this one, so we'll take another look at the possible fumble. So after the review, they reversed the call on the field. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 33. Got it to his man on the screen. Tackle around the 24-yard line. Makes it to the 11.
Even if you're pulling for the other team, you've got to just admire this guy's speed. He is special.
After a decent run up the gut. He's taken down around the 8-yard line.
This defensive lineman's got the kind of size and strength where he can disrupt the play all by himself.
From the 8-yard line, it's third down. Flips it middle to the running back. They'll bring him down around the 10-yard line. That's a 2-yard loss.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
This one should be makeable. Nebraska could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Douglas fields at the goal line. And he's taken down at the 30. Got to wonder right now which offense is going to open this thing up a little bit.
I think the answer will be which offensive coordinator is willing to take a chance or two to try to open some plays up. Because right now, not only are they losing the battle up front, but they're really not testing the defense downfield at all.
And they make the stop at the 32-yard line. He's going left. Intercepted. Tackle made around the 48-yard line.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
First and 10. Ball on the 48. Nebraska is up by 3. The defender had it and then dropped it.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
About the 43-yard line. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Cornhuskers really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And he's taken down at the 19-yard line.
The option is all about timing, and on that play, the timing was just off. That's going to happen sometimes.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 19-yard line. They come out in an empty backfield. it in a hurry. He's tackled right around the 24-yard line.
And I think he's got a good rhythm going right now with his wide receivers. He hit him for a nice game.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Complete. He's got room. He gets hit out of bounds at the 33-yard line.
Nice job here by the quarterback of putting some air underneath this pass and letting his receiver catch up with it for a nice game.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. And he's tackled around the 44-yard line.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Out of bounds at the 48-yard line. Defense looked like it jumped early there. So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. It's first and 10. Ball on the 45.
Mike three.
He scrambled. Looks to him again, complete. And down he goes at the 27-yard line. Around the 17-yard line.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
He makes it out to maybe the 16-yard line. Makes it out to about the 14-yard line.
Here we go, let's bring it. Let's go, let's bring it. Let's bring it. Mike three.
They'll run it inside and tackle quickly. This one away. It's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. Minnesota can tie it up here with this kick. Kicks up, and it sails through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Robinson takes it from the six. And the kicker comes in to make the tackle. You know, a lot of people in college football might find these types of games boring. But if you look at the start of this game, this is good old-fashioned football, partner.
I agree with you, Brad. I think sometimes you look at games, and if it's sloppy offense, that's one thing. But when you see two defenses go out and play with a great deal of emotion and dominate a football game, sign me up for that every time.
Gains his way to the 46-yard line. No one open, so he's going to run. And he's leveled with the 38-yard line.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
Nice run up the middle. We played one quarter, and this one's knotted up at three. We're all tied up, and more action coming, hopefully, here in quarter number two. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. He's at the 20. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice gain. Nice run there. The six. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
29 is Mike 29. Go.
They bring him down in the backfield. Loss of a yard.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Three here. Nebraska is looking to go up by 3. It's up, and it is good. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Douglas fields it at the 3. Tackle at the 26-yard line.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with. Because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game, but the offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
And they get nice yardage on that run. It's a great tackle at the 23.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
It's now third down and long. 13 yards to go for the first down after the sack. He goes downtown. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds. Throws incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Quick toss. Quick throw, caught, touchdown. Converts the extra point. A 6-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
So our score, 10-6. Walker gets set to kick this one away. Robinson from the 3, across the 30. He's tackled at the 35-yard line.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a t-shirt that says finish, finish, whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to the opponent's territory.
Scrambling around. He's taken down at about the 39-yard line. Makes it out to about the 41-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 43. Scrambling. And they make the stop at the 38.
Man left, man left. Four down. Mike 55. Ready. Go.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Him down in the backfield. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for a very long field goal attempt. The kick is up. No good. He pushed it to the right. This offense threw the ball extremely well on their last drive, and they ended up with a touchdown.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
Minnesota holds a four-point lead. Quick release. Oh, had it knocked down. Third down and 7. Ball on the 40-yard line. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. Tackle made right around the 46-yard line. Fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted. And he hits him hard at the 36. And he probably should never have thrown that ball.
When your receivers are covered like that, sometimes as a quarterback, it's better to just take the sack than take your chances with a throw.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. He's at midfield, and he tackles him hard at the 47. Gets to about the 44-yard line. Makes it to the 31.
I got it. 29 is the mic. Mic 29.
Tackled after a decent pickup. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Key 26.
Watch the run. Brought down at the 24. Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Taken down at the 29-yard line.
Football will change hands as they fail to convert on fourth down.
The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Makes the grab and steps out right away. Ball on their own 45.
I got you, punk. 31 to fight.
Minnesota is up by four. Completes. It's the junior. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
Got a man tackled for a loss. 5-yard loss on the play.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
He throws it. He's hit and taken down. First and goal. Quick throw in the end zone, touchdown. The extra point. It was a 7-play, 70-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Robinson from the one. Tackle made at the 25-yard line. Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. It up the middle for a nice run. Mills gains around 6 yards on the run. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And he's tackled at the 43-yard line.
Well, they found some seams in the coverage there. Let's see if the defense makes any adjustments to counter.
He gets it up. And it's no good. It lands short. This one's going to be well short, and they're going to have a chance to return it. And down he goes, right around the 26-yard line. And that'll do it. We head to the break. Still plenty of time left in this one. Minnesota's in front by 11.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. I'm sure both teams had problems in the first half, but one of them, David, not moving the football. Both offenses really ran up and down the field.
We see this more in college football, Reese. More success on the offensive side, and it's harder and harder to stop these offenses that continue to get more and more complicated. The defenses, they got no answer. They got to find an answer quick, or else this ballgame is just going to go tick for tack the whole second half.
That'll do it here in the studio at halftime. We'll try to see if Pollack can bring a little energy in the second half. Got a lot of games to watch, including yours. Brad and Kirk, ready for the second half. The Golden Gophers punched it in a couple of times in the first half, and now that coaching staff is hoping for more and more and more. See if Brad Nessler's got a deep well of touchdown calls. Brad and Kirk with the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. Wiley from the six. They'll bring him down at the 29. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. To around the 42.
Tight, guys, double tight. Two down, two down. Mike three! Mike three! Ready! Check, 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 check.
Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 42. Over the middle, it's intercepted. He's at the 40. Tackle around the 38-yard line.
That's exactly what they needed, Brad. Somehow to get the football back to their own offense. They need points on the board, and they need them in a hurry. And that turnover could help them out.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38. For his man, incomplete. Straight up the middle, and he'll lose yardage. Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. He's in trouble, throwing right, and they couldn't hook up on that one. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. Kicks up, and it falls short. No good. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Gets to about the 41-yard line. He's on the run, and he's level at the 44. Up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's taken down around the 44-yard line. Crawford to punt. He's out to the 30.
He gets out to about the 32-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. He makes it to the 35-yard line. Throws in the middle, and he's immediately tackled. Douglas awaiting the return. Douglas fields it at the 22, and down he goes at the 29-yard line. And for Morgan, it's been one of those days he'd like to forget.
Well, he's definitely very, very fortunate that the rest of his team around him has been able to step up and be able to bail him out from some of the mistakes that he's made. So they're still winning this game, and hopefully he's going to start to play a lot better.
Still a lot of time to make amends. Not a lot of success for this offense on their last trip out. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. To the left side, and he's brought down in the backfield. From their own 27-yard line, third down. He lets it fly. And it's going the other way. It's the senior corner. And he is drilled at the 31-yard line.
What kind of call is that? With a big lead, you're throwing the football, and the interception here could end up costing you.
From their own 31-yard line, first down. He's tackled after positive yardage. Martinez gets about 4 yards on the option keeper. There's a strike complete. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line. After a decent run up the gut.
Roger, Roger.
He has some room.
Shut down, shut down.
Gains his way to the 30-yard line. Big opening. Makes it out to about the 20. And this is the eighth play of the drive. And they make the stop at the 11.
Ready? 29 is the mic. Mike 29. Let's go. Fuck you.
he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. Throwing, I don't think he got anything on that. Tackle made at the 2-yard line. It's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. It's up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Nebraska is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
Quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out.
I would be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
Looks middle, got his back.
It could be that the offensive coordinator is trying to lure the secondary in to play more press coverage. And then they'll try to take advantage by going deep. Those safeties better be ready.
Good outside run there. So he holds on to it and gets a good 5 yards. Minnesota holds an 8-point advantage. Hands it to the back. Tackled for a loss.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Tackle at the 46-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Brought down right around the 42-yard line. From their own 42-yard line, it's second down. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. And folks, it's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. The Golden Gophers in front by 8. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4.
29 is Mike. Mike 29.
Let's go. They tried to get a head start there.
Red 58.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 44. The screen pass gets it to the back. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop, and now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. Wiley is the deep man awaiting the return. He takes it in at the 14. And he's taken down at the 29. He did a good job there to give his team decent field position. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. Minnesota up by 8. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Hit before it could go anywhere.
I got it. Mike three. Humble.
Ready. Eagle.
And he tackles him hard at the 44-yard line. Around the 47-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
And he's tackled at the 45.
Hey, not a huge play, but an effective play nonetheless. Able to pick up the first down. Again, this offense right now just making good decisions, moving the sticks, and maintaining possession of the football.
Pass incomplete.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
From the 45-yard line, second down.
Easy. Delta! Screen
pass. He's got his halfback. He gets hit out of bounds around the 32-yard line. Down for a sack on the play. So the sack makes this a second and long. Minnesota is up by 8. Tackled right away.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
First and 10. Ball on the 14-yard line. Takes it right and brought down right away.
He's really quick with his lateral movement, especially for a guy this big. He got to the ball carrier before he could get out of the backfield.
Gets it out quickly. And down he goes around the 5-yard line.
He looked totally in control on that keeper.
And he adds the extra point. So an 11-play, 60-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. So our score, 24-9. Walker looks ready to kick this one off. Johnson from the 2. He's taken down at the 28-yard line. Their last drive broke down and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? He makes his way to about the 38. Makes it out to about the 46. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Run up the middle.
Not over here. Not over here. Not over here. Let's go.
Tackle around the 40-yard line. Give to the tailback. He gets out to about the 38-yard line.
Let's go, D. Let's go, D.
Third and five coming up. Ball on the 38-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Trying to set up a little screen. Gets it to his tailback. He's pushed out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Empty backfield with five wide receivers. He's going to try and scramble. And he hits him hard at the 36. A touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Second and eight coming up here. Ball on the 38-yard line. Carries the ball for a nice gain. The Cornhuskers will use their first time out of the half. He's taken down around the 45-yard line. An incredible series for the defense, and they get him out after three plays.
That offense has to regroup and come up with a plan to move the ball down the field next time.
He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. It's first and 10. Ball on the 13-yard line. Five wide. Complete and taken down immediately. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And he stops the clock with a spike. He fights forward to about the 20. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. He throws it.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
You know they'd like to do something a little more than they did on their last drive when they had to punt the ball away.
Mike three.
He gets out to about the 18-yard line. The running back gets two on the carry. From the 18-yard line, it's second down. Makes it out to about the 10. Forward to about the 10. This one's all but wrapped up. Golden Gophers with a victory, 24-9. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.